as the quarter.
Well, a projection good. So he remains at four personal fouls. Take one away, so that's three on Shen Goon. We're going to have 5 minutes to win. Three, blocked by Claxton. Ball bobbled by Shen Goon. Behind the back with it. Smith fed by Johnson. Smith short jumper doesn't go. Claxton couldn't grab it. Shen Goon does. Shen Goon brings it down low. He just flips it around the perimeter for extra feed. Smith drives in. Missed it. That's pushing transition. O'Neal waiting for his teammates. Swing. Johnson. Rainbow three. Does he go? Brooklyn in front.
That's an excellent move.
104-103. Rockets. Jalen Green drive. Foul called on Brooklyn. That's team foul number three. Green has been on the hard one a bit tonight. Now, Kenyon Martin Jr. will check in for Houston. Claxton, and it left O'Neal on an island.
And take a look right here. Everyone's around Shen Goon trying to box him out. It's just an early jump there coming over the top off the longer rebound. Shen Goon comes up with it, flailing a little bit as he goes up with that shot.
That's four team fouls against Brooklyn. Houston up by four. Shen Goon, 21 points, 9 boards. And Houston is out-rebounded the Nets by 10 boards, 48-38. Dinwiddie against Shen Goon. Dinwiddie wants to dance. Drives, scoops, missed it.
So, Ian, that's if they take an advantage with the switches here. You know, Claxton can defend out on the perimeter, obviously, multiple positions. There is a quickness to Green and the attack, his ability to get around. But that's also exploited and forced that vulnerability on the offensive glass for the Rockets when they've got a guy like Shen Goon with a small player trying to box him out.
So that's 5 team fouls against the Nets, 0 team fouls for Houston.
From behind by Claxton, just on the second thing the official saw.
And another offensive rebound. Shen Goon gets around Claxton, swing it for the Green jumper, in and out. Johnson the board. Nets are down by 5. Bridges with a jab. Picked up by Porter. Double team. Bridges loses it. Out of bounds. Houston touched it last with 11 to shoot.
And we've seen that a couple times, whether it's come to fruition or they just stunt at him trying to trap Bridges. I would expect you'll see more of that and just looking to get the ball out of his hands here on this end.
Johnson gets it in for Claxton. Johnson bounces. Claxton finishes.
And Cam Johnson taking advantage of the swish. Perfect bounce. Nice throw down by Claxton. I mean, you couldn't have scripted that and executed it any better if you were Brooklyn. However, again, Houston runs it back here.
In this case, let's look. challenge.
Officials trying to work it out.
With no foul calls. Now Tony Brothers, the crew chief for Justin Van Dyne and Andy Nagy. Let's go back to it again. Butler saying there was. Justin Van Dyne, Tony Brothers following up. Andy Nagy, the official who made the call.
This is why they should be able to review it. Why they're wasting all this time
against Miami. So if they were to win tonight and the Knicks were to beat the Heat, you're talking about a game changer for that number six spot in the Eastern Conference. Jalen Green to the free throw line. Houston now up by four.
And all our viewers know the reason there is so much emphasis on the sixth spot is that it keeps you out of the game, the play-in tournament. And I think that this is also good offense. So these guys will get a chance to get some rest, get a break, and start preparing for the first round matchup.
And that's down by five. Dinwiddie. Bridges, O'Neal, Claxton, Bridges, swing it for Johnson. They get O'Neal the ball. Good three. Plus 12. 110, 108, 244 to go. Offensive rebound to an issue. 28. Fever targets. Kick for Marcus Warner, the factor. Once again, Claxton drawing the assignment. The spin by Martin, a big shot, no. And the rebound tracked down by Bridges. Nets are 6 of 7 from downtown in the fourth quarter. Double team on Bridges, trying to fight through it. Foul call. 2:50.
Really upset with the call. Quickly, Knicks at the foul line are 10 of 20 on the night and still lead by 9.
This man, one of the best on the team, continues to struggle. Inexplicably, they are missing all these free throws. Look at the coach. He's our